Yellow Productions.
How to ride New York City's subway. I'm Chris, this is Yellow Productions. I do travel guides that are fun, informative, and entertaining. This is part of my series of travel guides on New York. In this one, I'm gonna be telling you everything you need to know to ride this subway. I'm breaking it down into 9 different tips, give you some general information first, then I'll talk about buying tickets, finding the station, getting in the station, getting on the train, getting off the train, exiting the station, and then some concluding remarks. If you wanna watch some of my other videos from New York, you can click one of these cards up here, find the link in the description below, or you'll find the link to my New York City playlist at the end of this video. Let me first start with some general information about New York City's subway. It is a very big subway system. It has 472 stations serving 27 lines, and it operates 24 hours a day. The routes are typically numbered or lettered, so 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. There's a few different types of trains. There's rapid trains, or they call them express trains, and then there's local trains. The local trains stop at every stop. The express trains stop every few stops. They skip some. If you're looking at the map of the subway, you will find the white circles are the express and the local stops. The black circles are only the local trains. You should pay attention to directions when you see things like uptown. If you're in Manhattan, that's typically North Manhattan. If you see downtown, that's typically South Manhattan. Also, you really want to pay attention to the stations and the directions that they go, because sometimes a certain station entrance will only be going a certain direction. And if you go in the subway, you can't often just exit again. And you don't want to make a costly $2.75 mistake because you went in the wrong entrance. The second tip for riding the New York City subway is to plan your trip. And for planning your trip, don't be old school. Don't use a paper map, or don't just try to get to the station and figure out where you're going, but use an app. Come into the 21st century. Google Maps will do it in a pinch, but one of the best ones, I think, is called City Mapper. One of the great things about City Mapper, it's much more detailed than Google Maps is. You put in where you want to go, you hit go, it'll give you a route. But in addition to giving you the route, it'll tell you things like you walk a little bit, it'll give you the times for the trains, and then it'll even tell you things like what's the best section of the train to be in to transfer. It'll tell you how long it is to transfer. It'll tell you how many stops to go, and it'll all work while you're on the train too, and it'll show you where you're going on the connection. So definitely get the City Mapper app. It's for Android and iPhone. The third thing to know is about buying tickets, and there'll be these types of ticket machines at the subway stations. These accept credit cards only. These big ones accept credit cards or cash. Simply put, you don't really want to buy single ride tickets. You want to buy one of the reloadable cards. You can do a single ride if you're only going to be here for one ride, and it is $3 for a single ride. It's good for only 2 hours of purchase, but what you want to do is you want to get a Metro card, and then you can say get new card. It costs $1 to buy the card. You can either get a regular Metro card that you fill up with a certain amount of money. Every ride is $2.75, so this one will give you 2 rides, for example. Or you could get the unlimited ride card. Depends how long you'll be here. You can see 7 days is $32, a month is $121, and if you want to add buses, that is a little bit more for the express buses. Once you're done with the machine, out will come a shiny new Metro card like this. I'll point out this is not an IC card, it's a magnetic stripe card. The magnetic stripe is right here. Once you've got this, you'll swipe this through the turnstiles over there to get in. If you ever want to know how much money is on your Metro card, you can use these machines too. You just say Metro card, get card info. There's a little thing over here. You put the card in, and then it will tell you how much money you have on your card. Now that you planned your route, you know what station you want to go to, and you got your Metro card, it's time to get in. Make sure the station you're getting into, you get in for the correct route or line. You'll see the numbers, the letters, the colors, and so make sure you're also going in the right direction. If it's a staircase entrance, it'll typically have some lights on the top. If you see green lights on the top, that means it's a 24-hour entrance. If you see red lights, that means it's an exit only or a part-time entrance. Once you're in the station, to get in the part where you can actually get on the train, you have to swipe your Metro card at the turnstile. It'll either be a waist-high turnstile or a full-height turnstile. Swipe your Metro card with the mag stripe facing you at kind of a medium speed. You just have to get the hang of it. I don't have a better description for the speed other than that. Too fast or too slow, it won't work. Now that you are in the station, you need to find your train. Look for the route, the letter or number, and the direction. direction up on the overhead signs. In big stations, you may be walking up to 15 minutes to find the platform for your train. And also make sure it's the correct direction. Uptown is typically north in Manhattan, and downtown, again, is typically south. Okay, so you found the platform. Now just get on your train. When it gets here, make sure you get on the correct local or express train. But when you're riding the train, seriously, don't bother listening to the announcements. The speakers are usually lousy. The microphones are lousy from the train operators. They've got thick New York accents. The best way is just to count your stops. If you use the City Mapper app that I told you about earlier, you'll know how many stops. 5 stops. You just get off at that stop. Also, it can be worthwhile knowing the stop before your stop so you can see the station just outside when you get there, and you'll know your stop is the next one. Also, when you're riding the train, don't stare at the people on the train. Don't get on an empty car. There's a reason why people aren't in it. It is either hot or it smells. If you're wearing a backpack, remove it so you don't bump into people or stuff doesn't get stolen out of it. Stay awake. Don't fall asleep, because otherwise people might steal your stuff or you might miss your stop. But yes, there are pickpockets on the New York City subway, so do be careful. If you're standing, make sure to hold on to the railing because the trains do stop and rock and restart suddenly. Locals might not be holding on, but they're used to it. And if you're watching this video, well, chances are you are not used to it. Now that you're at your stop, you need to exit the station. If you use the City Mapper app and it has a few stations, it'll tell you what exit to go out of. So take a look at the overhead signs to find the correct exit. When you get to the turnstile, you don't need to swipe out, just push out. Your Metro card is valid for transfers up to 2 hours after you swiped it into the subway. You can go from the subway to the bus or bus to a subway, but not subway to subway. For a transfer to work in New York City, you basically have to ride a bus at some point. And finally, when you're all done, go wash your hands or use some hand sanitizer when you leave the subway. It can be kind of germy. Definitely don't eat anything until your hands are clean. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please click on this yellow ball to subscribe. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, or Instagram, or click here to watch some of my other videos from my New York series. You know you want to. All right, thanks. Bye-bye.